प्रैक्टिकल सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम। हाय, वेलकम टू न्यूटेक यूट्यूब चैनल। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू परफॉर्म प्रैक्टिकल ऑफ सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम यूजिंग मल्टीसिम सॉफ्टवेयर। लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड एक्चुअल सर्किट यूज्ड इन एक्सपेरिमेंटल सेटअप ऑफ सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम। इन सर्किट डायग्राम वी हैव सिलेक्टेड थ्री रजिस्टर्स R1, R2 एंड R3 ऑफ 10 ओम, 20 ओम एंड 30 ओम रिस्पेक्टिवली विथ टू सिंगल पोल डबल थ्रो SPDT स्विचेस and two voltage sources V1 and V2. Now we are performing practical of mesh analysis using multisim software. Let's start. In workspace we are going to construct actual circuit of superposition theorem. From component toolbox select a DC source, first source V1, then select second source V2, again select a ground. Close the component toolbox. Again, from component toolbox, select SPDT switch for supply source V1 and second SPDT switch for supply voltage V2. Then select the resistors, resistor R1, resistor R2, and resistor R3. Then close the component toolbox. Please orient the SPDT switch by selecting flip horizontal of J1 switch, then flip the or rotate resistor R2 by 90 degree clockwise. In superposition theorem, we are performing practical by switching on voltage source V1 for 3 consecutive readings. Similarly, by switching on supply voltage V2 for consecutive 3 set of readings, then we are making supply voltage V1 and V2 on simultaneously, and at that time we are measuring currents flowing through resistor R1, R2 and resistor R3. Then select 3 multimeters, multimeter 1 which measures the current flowing through resistor R1, multimeter 2 measures the current flowing through resistor R3, and multimeter 3 measures the current flowing through resistor R3. Now make the connections. V1 is connected to the switch 1 in series with multimeter to the resistor R1. R1 and R3 is connected, and connect the multimeter 2 in series with resistor R2. Similarly, connect multimeter 3 in between resistor R2 and switch J2. Connect supply voltage V2 to the switch J2, and the negative terminal of supply voltage V1 and V2 must be connected to the ground, as well as connect resistor R2 to the ground. Now connect second terminal of switch to the ground, because we want to make on voltage source V1 and V2 separately. Then double click on multimeter 1, it shows its display window. Similarly, double click on multimeter 2 and multimeter 3. Set all 3 multimeters at DC emitter range. Now, before starting out the simulation, please set the values of as a 10 ohm, 20 ohm and 30 ohm. Similarly, set voltage V1 at 10 volt and voltage V2 at
12 volt. Now start the simulation. Now source V1 must be on and V2 must be connected to the ground. Okay, this is our first setup reading when supply V1 is on. Then run the simulation. We get first setup reading current I1 dash is equal to 454.545 milliampere. Current I2 dash is equal to 272.728 milliampere. And current I3 dash is equal to 181.818 milliampere. Then stop the simulation. Again set voltage V1 at 20 volt. We get second setup readings. Current I1 dash is equal to 909.09 milliampere. Current I2 dash is equal to 454.455 milliampere. And current I3 dash is equal to 363.636 milliampere. Now stop the simulation and set V1 at 30 volt. Then we get third set of readings. Current I1 dash is equal to 1.364 ampere. Current I2 dash is equal to 818.183 milliampere. And current I3 dash is equal to 545.455 milliampere. Then stop the simulation. Change the position of J1 switch to the ground, means we are making V1 is off, and change the position of J2 switch to on condition and set V2 at 12 volt. Then start the simulation. We get first set of readings. 1 double dash is equal to minus 218.182 milliampere. Current I2 double dash is equal to 109.091 milliampere. Current I3 double dash is minus 327.271 milliampere. Then stop the simulation. Set V2 at 25 volt. We get second set of readings as I1 double dash is equal to minus 454.546 milliampere. I2 double dash is equal to 227.272 milliampere, and I3 double dash is minus 681.815 milliampere. Then set V2 at 35 volt. We get third set of reading when V2 is on. I1 double dash is minus 636.364 milliampere. I2 double dash is 318.182 milliampere, and I3 double dash as 954.543 milliampere. We completed V2 is on condition and V1 is off condition. Now stop the simulation. Make V1 on and V2 on. Then set V1 at 12 volt and V2 at set V1 at 10 volt and V2 at 12 volt. Then run the simulation. In this condition, we applied both the sources to a given circuit at a time. We get first reading I1 is equal to 236.362 milliampere. I2 is equal to 381.818 milliampere, and I3 is equal to minus 145.452 milliampere. Then stop the simulation. Set V1 at 20 volt and V2 at 25 volt. Then second set of reading, we get I1 is equal to 454.545 milliampere. I2 is equal to 772.728 milliampere, and I3 is equal to minus 318.177 milliampere. Now get third set of reading. Set V1 is equal to 30 volt and V2 is equal to 35 volt. we get third set of reading as I1 is equal to 727.269 milliampere, I2 is equal to 1.136 ampere, and I3 is equal to minus 409.088 milliampere. Then stop the simulation. In this way, we are applied two voltage sources V1 and V2 simultaneously in a given circuit and verified the superposition theorem.
Now see observations. For range of voltages V1 of 10 volt, 20 volt and 30 volt, also range of voltages V2 of 12 volt, 25 volt and 35 volt, we are observed when source V1 is on, measured currents I1 dash, I2 dash and I3 dash. Similarly, when source V2 is on, measured currents I1 double dash, I2 double dash and I3 double dash respectively. And when both voltage sources V1 and V2 on, we have measured currents I1, I2 and I3. Now see calculations. Also calculated values of currents I1 dash, I2 dash and I3 dash when source V1 is on. Then calculated values of currents I1 double dash, I2 double dash and I3 double dash, and again when both voltage sources V1 and V2 on, we have measured currents I1, I2 and I3 respectively. In this video, we have performed practical of superposition theorem using multisim software.
Please like, share and subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get new video updates. Thanks for watching my YouTube channel. Thank you.